December nights in Balboa Park has been a tradition in San Diego since 1978. It was originally called Christmas on the Prado and had its name changed at the turn of the century in 2002. The renaming was met with some resistance by those who wanted tradition over political correctness. Over the years, it was gradually accepted, and December Nights has grown into a holiday celebration that's more inclusive for everyone and features various cultures in the San Diego community, as well as those from around the world. It's held annually on the first Friday and Saturday every December. December Nights is the largest free community event in the city of San Diego. It attracts upwards of 300,000 guests from around San Diego County and regions of Southern California. Arriving and departing the event leads to traffic delays. The closest parking spots have fees, although free parking is available at the zoo and the San Diego Community College parking structures. Several stages are set up around Balboa Park for over 1,600 dancers, musicians, actors, and entertainers. The numerous stages have concurrent schedules, so viewing one show means you'll miss a handful of others. One of the stages is hidden in the courtyard of the Casa del Prado and is used mainly for the San Diego Civic Dance Association. The choreography here is more advanced, and these students often move into careers in dance and the performing arts. The sound of bagpipes can be heard near the international cottages. They have worldwide appeal and are known for the sustained droning sound from the bass and two tenor pipes which extend upward from the bag. Many types of bagpipes exist, and the Great Highland Bagpipe has become a symbol that represents Scotland. Strangely enough, bagpipes did not originate in Scotland. Some historians have traced them back to Egypt around 400 BC. Various forms of bagpipes have been constructed and played throughout Europe, the Middle East, and Asia. The Romans brought to Scotland an earlier form, which would later evolve into the Great Highland Bagpipe. It's the most prominent version that people think of when referring to bagpipes. In addition to the drone pipes, the blowstick on the left allows for the piper to constantly fill the bag with air. The chanter below has finger holes to play the melody in a one-octave range. The left arm is then used to squeeze the bag against the body, forcing air through the drones and the chanter to produce sound. The bag acts as a third lung in this manner, and allows for sustained notes throughout the entire song. Bagpipes were used as folk instruments, contributed to court music, and were even used in times of war. They were played on the battlefields of both world wars, among others, to motivate the troops for battle and to intimidate the enemy. Along with drums, bagpipes signaled tactical movements, orders, and firing of weapons. Over the noise of battle, the Great Highland Bagpipe can play around 110 decibels, about the same loudness as a jackhammer or power saw. For distance comparison, a male human voice can travel about 600 feet and still be understood, whereas a Great Highland Bagpipe can be heard over a distance of 10 miles. After an uprising in 1745, the wearing of full Highland dress was outlawed to bring Scottish clans under control. In addition, the playing of bagpipes was also suppressed. The first offense would earn 6 months of prison time, and the second offense, banishment from the country for 7 years. Other countries, such as France, Italy, and Spain, have their own respective versions of bagpipes, and these are played in international competitions and festivals, just like here at December Nights. One of the few places to sit down at the event are the packed rows of the Spreckles Organ Pavilion, lighted in holiday colors. On the first night of the celebration, the crowds gathered to hear an official greeting by the mayor to December Nights. The kickoff to the holiday season starts with a countdown for the tree lighting ceremony. 200 vendor booths are scattered throughout the entirety of Balboa Park. Most are concentrated on the Prado, from the fountain near the Natural History Museum, across the plaza in front of the Museum of Art, to the quadrangle below the California Tower. Other vendors are located near the Spreckles Organ Pavilion, at the parking lot near the Comic-Con Museum, and in the Spanish Village near the San Diego Zoo. Like other festivals conducted on a grand scale, food is a main attraction for many in attendance. Whatever delicacy or delight that may be real or imagined can be found at December Nights. Let's cue up the Amen break. Bomb Bomb Bakehouse, Ube Bread Box, Asian plates, milkshakes, lumpia and funnel cakes, chicken bowls, egg rolls, Hawaiian barbecue, jambalaya, shepherd's pie, desserts and macaroons, mini burgers, dumplings and bowls of rice, brazuca bites, fish, taco, strawberry delights, shortbread cookies, donuts with mochi, chili cheese fries and dim sum guy, kettle corn, corn dogs, corn in a cup, tacos de canasta and chipuda served up. Now that we've dropped the mic, let's take another look at the mochi donuts. The focus on food is emphasized with CBS 8 at Chef Buddha. The Food Network is also filming an episode of Carnival Eats. The municipal gym is set up for families. The kids try out their golf swings. Lights are hung around the path to see Santa Claus. Outside, colorful lights decorate Balboa Park to create a festive atmosphere and give visitors a chance to experience the holidays among an extended community of family and friends. As night falls, Santa rides his sleigh toward the Organ Pavilion. The lights shine an even brighter canopy of light, stretching above everyone. Across the plaza, it's cold darkness, except for the scene on the right of the Museum of Art. Against the backdrop of winter, a fiery display will be on stage as flamenco artists prepare for their show. Flamenco is a passionate, intense form of dancing that originated from the Andalusian region of southern Spain. It's known for its regal postures, hand clapping, quick movements, and vigorous foot stamping. The typical form involves a dancer, a guitar, and vocals. There are different styles or forms called palos, or sticks, each with its own rhythm, melody, and characteristics. Flamenco was originally focused on singing, especially during its rise in popularity in the Romantic period of the early to mid-1800s. In 1881, Silverio Franconetti opened the first flamenco café. Although he was a singer himself, Franconetti directed the focus more on the flamenco dancers, using the vocals and guitar to serve as a supporting role to entertain the audience. Flamenco dancing is a combination of choreographed movements and improvisation using a repertoire of steps that fit within the framework of the music. When creating a live performance, the dancer, vocalist, and guitarist have a hidden way of conveying their cues between one another. The dancer can speed up the tempo by performing a subida step, which means to rise, stamping her shoes faster and faster, which the musicians follow. If the guitarist is playing a melody, the dancer will move her arms and hands to emphasize the emotion and keep her feet quiet in order to allow room for the music to take the center stage. The singer will watch the dancer for a llamada step. It translates to call and is a series of steps to close off a section of the performance and also acts as a cue for the singer to start singing again. Various accessories are used in flamenco dancing. Castanets are shell-shaped percussion instruments held within each hand. They are used in specific dances of flamenco and include techniques of clicks, rolls, and strikes. They add another layer of rhythm on top of the existing music and stamping shoes of the dancer. A fan can add graceful and dramatic accents to complement the dancer's movements. It can be opened, closed, or manipulated to face the direction of the dancer's focus or highlight the posture of her body. A shawl can be draped over the shoulders or held in the hands and spun in the air to spotlight elegant, flowing movements. A traditional style of shawl will feature intricate embroidery and vibrant colors. A train skirt called bata de cola has flowing fabric ruffles that trail the dancer's movements. It adds a technical challenge of not only dancing with the music, but also extra awareness to manage the position of the train. The dancer must modify her steps to lift the train while performing turns, and allow for additional beats for the weight of the dress to settle after executing a pattern. The traditional flamenco dress extends to the ankle, allowing the dancer to showcase intricate footwork while maintaining the elegance and style of a full-length dress. Ruffles and frills are typical in its design, and floral patterns are often included. Possibly the most important part of a flamenco dancer's outfit are the shoes. Women's shoes are made with a low to moderate height for stability and comfort. Tiny nails are hammered and flattened into the toes and the heels, which produce the characteristic percussive sound of flamenco when striking the ground. The shoes are meant to provide good support with adequate ventilation and aesthetic appeal to supplement the dancer's movements. Although flamenco embodies power and focused intensity, even the most experienced flamenco dancers work playful steps into their routine to remind us, as well as themselves, that flamenco is meant to uplift our hearts and our spirits. During December nights, almost all museums at Balboa Park are open to the public for free. There are about 18 museums, and it's difficult to fit them in one night. But it's a good opportunity to get a glimpse inside a museum you've been waiting to see. Balboa Park does appreciate patronage of locals from San Diego, and holds resident free days on certain Tuesdays each month. It's worth searching online to take advantage of these offers throughout the year. Another easy way to see the museums of Balboa Park is to search for and watch the other videos on this channel, San Diego Review. Some include venues such as the Comic-Con Museum, the Air and Space Museum, and the Museum of Art. A mini halfpipe is set up for skaters to practice moves and promote drinking milk for strong bones. The skaters used it to practice new tricks, too. Mariachi are groups of musicians that perform a variety of traditional Mexican songs, from ballads and serenades to folk music and dance accompaniment. The name mariachi has a handful of origin stories. Some are more believable than others. One story proposed that mariachi came from the French word for marriage. Why would something so inherently Mexican be associated with France? Here's a possible explanation. Cinco de Mayo is celebrated in the United States as a date of Mexican-American culture and is linked to the exact date, May 5, 1862, at the Battle of Puebla, where 4,500 Mexican troops fought off and defeated a better-equipped French army of 6,000. Despite this victory, France took control of Mexico the following year and held power until 1867. During this time, however, the French observed these groups playing music at Mexican weddings and would hire them to play at their own weddings. They referred to the music as their French word for marriage, mariage. These musicians would eventually be known as mariachi. The origin of the word mariachi may predate French occupation to either the Nayarit or Jalisco states in Mexico, where indigenous languages use the word to mean the platform of wood, referencing the stage or dance floor, or perhaps even wood of the guitar. Whatever the origins of the term mariachi, their music is enjoyed by all who hear it today. A typical mariachi band is made up of violins, rhythm and bass guitars, harp, trumpets, and voice. This collection of instruments provides a rich sonorous sound, supporting the lyrics, which portray celebration or tragedy, romance, folklore, along with Mexican identity and pride. There is no strict rule about mariachis having a band leader. Different members of the band will often sing the lead vocals to add variety, showcase their versatility, and adjust the sound to match the emotion of each song played. The mariachis work as an ensemble, collaborating toward the overall sound of the group. Mastering their instruments, as well as the precise intonation of their vocals, mariachis are true musicians in every sense of the word. Local artists and vendors sell handmade arts and crafts that are ideal for presents and gifts. Here are lenticulars that change when viewed at different angles. You can see more like these by watching the San Diego Review for the Institute of Contemporary Art. There are beanies designed for the holidays, adorned with blinking lights, Japanese anime hats and accessories, fragrant candles that look like tiny plants, heart-shaped dream catchers, necklaces, bracelets, trays and trays of rings, colorful pottery and candles, cartoon bottles for drinks, decorations that light from the inside, winter hats, assorted patches, vibrant art, vibrant glass, artwork in the Spanish village, stars, bowls, and cups, and owls who stare back at us. Here's a festival of trees that showcases how the winter season is celebrated from countries around the world. There's also a reindeer caught here between all the decorations, and after seeing December nights, had decided to call it a day. If you enjoyed this video and all the original music, help this channel grow for free. Leave a comment below, click like, share this video and channel with others, and click the button to subscribe. Thanks for watching San Diego Review.